So let's talk about determine the current through 5 ohm resistor. Okay, we have to determine the current flowing through this 5 ohm resistor. How we will proceed? We will apply mesh analysis. Okay, so in order to you need to calculate the meshes. So this is a mesh 1, mesh 2, mesh 3. Okay, now let's number the meshes. This is my mesh 1. I will assume a current I1. Okay, this is a mesh 2. I will assume current I2. Similarly for mesh 3, I will assume current I3. So now I will write the equation for mesh 1. So let's write the apply KVL. You need to apply KVL in order to write the mesh equation. Okay, apply KVL equation to mesh 1. So this is your mesh 1. As you can see, there is a 8 volt battery, 2 ohm resistor and 1 ohm resistor. But see, the 1 ohm resistor is common between mesh 1 and mesh 2, and 2 ohm resistor is common between mesh 1 and mesh 3. So you have to remember that things before you apply KVL. Look at this diagram properly, analyze the circuit, then apply KVL. Let's see step by step. So see this I1, 1 ohm resistor, the current I1 is also flowing, I2 is also flowing, but I'm now looking for current I1. So I'm in mesh 1, so I1 minus I2. I will write 1 resistor value and then current value I1 minus I2. Then for second plus 2 ohm resistor, I will write the value of resistor, and then I will write I1 minus I3, and this equals to my 8 volt. Okay, this is your KVL equation. When I open the brackets, I1 minus I2 plus 2I1 minus 2I3 equal to 8. I will get equations. So you can see 2I1 and I1 will give you 3I1, and this you can see I2 is alone, so minus I2 over here and minus 2I3 will be 8. So I will mark this equation 1. Similarly, I will apply KVL to the mesh 2 part. So let's apply KVL to mesh. Apply KVL to mesh 2. This is my mesh 2. Let's apply it over here. As you can see, there is a 10 ohm battery. First, you need to analyze 10 volt battery. There is 1 ohm resistor. There is 4 ohm resistor. Okay. So I will write the resistor value over here. So let's see, 1 ohm resistor is common between mesh 2 and mesh 1. So now I'm looking for mesh 2. So it will be I2 minus I1. Remember, if you are writing the equation for mesh 2, you will consider the current of mesh 2 first. So it will be I2 minus I1. Then I will write a plus 4. For second resistor, you can see it is not common between any two, so it will be 4I2 equal to what is your battery value, that is voltage. Remember, this is negative, this is positive, so it is going from positive to negative. Remember this, it is going from, see, you can see the direction, see this arrow, it is going from negative to positive, so that means your voltage will be minus 10 over here. Why it is 8 over here? You can see this. This is the small terminal is your negative and the big terminal is your positive. So you can see my arrow is like this. It is going from negative to positive. So whenever your current goes from negative to positive, it will be positive value. You can see this 8 over here. And for in this case, it is going from negative to positive, so it is minus 10 over here. I will open the brackets and solve these values. So 1 into I2 is 1I2 minus I1 plus 4I2 will give you minus 10. I can see this I2, 4I2 and I2. What will it give? minus I1 plus 5I2 will be equal to minus 10. This is your equation 2. Now let's go and apply KVL to mesh 3. Let's do this. KVL to mesh 3. Let's apply KVL to mesh 3. You can see, first analyze this diagram. See, 5 ohm resistor is fine. So 5I3 and 2 ohm resistor is common between mesh 1 and mesh 2. So I'll write the value for 2 ohm resistor. See how you have to write this. Write the resistance value first, 2. Then check this. I3, I'm looking for mesh 3. So I3, and it is common between mesh 1. So I3 minus of I1 you will write over here. And then write this, 5 ohm. So it is plus 5 of, what is that, I3. And equal to the voltage. Voltage is 12 volt. Check the direction. This is negative to positive. It is going from negative to positive. That means it is positive. So it will be 12 volt. You have to note this. And so I will open the brackets. 2I3 minus 2I1 plus 5I3 equals to 12. So what will I get? I3 and I3, as you can see. So we'll get minus 2I1 plus 0I2. I can write the 0 because I2 term is absent over here, and I3 is 7I3. Okay, I am writing this 0 for a reason. Over here, I2 is not there, so 0I2. This is equation 3. So we got 3 equations by applying mesh 2, by applying KVL to mesh 1, 2 and 3 respectively. You will be getting 3 equations. Now the task is very simple. Just take your calculator. Go to the equation. So you can see, mode setup, then press equation. Equation is 5, so I will press 5 over here. You can see I am having I1, I2, I3 and 8. So I am having 4 terms. So I will select this second. Okay, press 2 over here. Then you will get like this. And then type the values. Okay, so 3I1. So I will write 3 over here. Okay, you need to just type this. Go on typing this value. Okay, 3I1 minus I2. So I will type minus 1. Okay, say this. Here it is 3I1. Okay, here it is minus 1. So I will type minus 1. Let's do this fast. Okay, check this. Properly fill this matrix. Then you have minus 2 over here. Minus 2, and then you have 8. D value will type 8. So you will be getting like this. Press equal to sign to enter the values. Then minus I1. Okay, look there. Look at this. Minus I1. Then you have 5I2. Then you have minus 10. Then minus 2. No. Yeah, we'll type it again. Check this, 3I1. So I will write 3, then minus 1, then minus 2, then 8. Then for second, minus 1, okay, 5, 0, and then minus 10 because I3 term is not there. Then for third equation, minus 2, 0, then you got 7, and then you got 12. So I will be getting the values. X is I1. I1 is 4.23. You can write down the values of I1 equal to 4.23. We are getting it from the calc. Similarly, I2 value is minus 1.15, I2 value is minus 1.15, okay, I3 value is equal to, press equal to and check it, 2.92, okay, 2.92. Okay, so these are your values for I1, I2, I3. Now you can see I have to find determine the current flowing through the 5 ohm resistor. So you can see 5 ohm resistor I3 value. So my I3 value is this. So current, you can write the final statement, current you're flowing through your 5 ohm resistor through 5 ohm resistor is 2.92 amperes. Okay, we can write denote is like this, I 5 ohm equals to 2.92 amperes. Okay, so this is the sum. So this is very easy, you just need to apply KVL and solve, and this is the basics.